Swami, you are welcome in online series of machine design. So in today's session we will learn about rolling contact bearing. In last lecture we have already seen that classification of basic classification of rolling contact bearing and classification of ball bearing with specifications, right? So in this lecture we will see about, or we will learn about, how to design a, or what are the designation of a ball bearing, or how you will identify whether it is medium load bearing, whether it is high load bearing, whether it is low capacity bearing. So this is depends on your designation of ball bearing. Okay, so designation of ball bearing, what is mean by designation of ball bearing? So bearings are basically designated by a number. Okay, so in general the number consists of at least 3 digit. Okay, so these designation of ball bearing is basic your consist of your 3 digit number. Okay, and last 3 digits gives the series. Okay, series and bore of the bearing. Okay, and last 2 digit from 04 onwards when multiplied by 5. Okay, 04 onward when we will multiply it by 5, so you will get the bore diameter. Means last 2 digit when multiplied by your 5, so you will get the bore diameter of bearing. Bore diameter means inner raised dia. Okay, where actually balls are placed. Okay, in last lecture we have seen that ki what is your inner race, outer race. Okay, so when we consider the bore diameter, means balls are placed inside of your inner race, so this is known as your bore diameter, right? So these are basically available in 4 types of designation. First is your, when it is used for the extra light load, right? So it is denoted by 100. Okay, when light load 200, when medium load it is denoted by 300, and when it is for heavy load, so it is designated by 400. Okay, so now understand by taking one example. I have explained designation of bearing is consist of basically your 3 digit number. When we multiply the last 2 digit number by your 5, so you will get the bore diameter. Now see here one example. If a bearing is designated by the number 305K. Okay, 300 means it is used for the medium load. Okay, so it means the bearing is used for the medium series. Okay, now what is the bore diameter? So last 2 digit is, what is the last 2 digit? So last 2 digit is 05. So when we will multiply 05 by your 5, so you can see here 05 multiplied by 5, so you will get the 25 mm. So this 25 mm is your bore diameter. K is used for specifically, for example, taper roller bearing. Okay, for example, nose bearing. So this is the different type of designation. Now here you can see here what I have explained, so you can understand by your this 2D diagram of your bearing. Okay, this top to bottom distance is known as your outside diameter, and where balls are placed inside of retainer is known as actually your bore, and lower portion is known as your bit. Okay, so this is your overall designation of, okay, designation, or you can say that standard dimension of ball bearing. So these are designed by this proportions. Now the thrust bearings are used to carry the thrust load. So what is thrust bearing? Thrust bearing, or you can say that thrust ball bearing. So thrust ball bearings are bearing when these bearings are used to carry out the, or to withstand your thrust load, means when load is applied at the axis of your rotation. So these type of bearing are used or known as thrust bearing. Okay, and these bearings, thrust bearings, are generally used at below the 2000 rpm. When speed of the shaft is above your 2000 RPM, we will not provide the thrust ball bearing, or we will not use the thrust ball bearing. Okay, there may be radial roller bearing may be applied, but we will not use thrust bearing, right? So at high speed, centrifugal forces causes the ball to be forced out of the recess. So what is the reason we will not use ball bearing above your 2000 RPM? Okay, so this is the reason. When they will at very high speed, so what will happen? Centrifugal force may be come in picture, and they will try to bring out your ball at the outside of your recess. So that's why we will not prefer to use a thrust ball bearing above your 2000 RPM, right? So you can see here radial bearing and thrust bearing. When load is at the perpendicular direction, so these are known as your radial bearing, and when load is act at your axis of direction, so these are known as your thrust bearing. Now, so at high speed, so which bearing is recommended and we will use at high speed? So at high speed, generally we will recommend it the angular contact ball bearing. Okay, so they can use in place of thrust bearing at very high speed. Okay, so radial bearing, thrust bearing, we have already seen that. Okay, now, so when we use roller in place of balls, then bearing is known as roller bearing. Okay, so again we have seen ball bearing. What are the limitation of ball bearing? Limitation of ball bearing was that it is used, we cannot use ball bearing above your 2000 RPM. Reason was what? Because centrifugal force will come in picture and they will bring out the ball out from the inner rays. Okay, so that's why we will not prefer to use ball bearing at high speed, right? So again, there is classification. So to overcome that problem, we can use the angular contact bearing, but in some cases angular ball bearing is not used also. Okay, so there is roller bearing may be come in picture. Okay, so what is roller bearing? When we use the roller in place of your ball, okay, so these ball bearings are known as your roller contact bearing. So what are the types of roller contact bearing? So these are basically four types. First is your cylindrical roller bearing, second one is your spherical, third one is your needle roller bearing, and fourth one is your tapered roller bearing. So these are the four types of your roller contact bearing, right? So one by one we will see all diagram, or one by one we will see the each and every classification of your roller contact bearing. So you can see here at one stage all types of bearing. First one is your cylindrical. When shape may be cylindrical, so these are known as cylindrical bearing. When shape may be spherical, okay, and spherical shape may be there for the insertion of roller, so these are known as spherical roller bearing. Similarly, when we use the needle, okay, needle like portion, so these are known as needle bearing. And taper, when we will provide some angle, these are not at horizontal, okay, so these bearings are known as your taper roller bearing. Now, so first one is your cylindrical roller bearing. Okay, so what is cylindrical roller bearing? These bearing have short rollers guided inside of cage. Okay, we have seen that inside of bearing there is cage or retainer may be provided. Okay, so these short rollers are used or guided in case, so these are known as your cylindrical roller bearing. Okay, so what is the basic specification of these type of bearing? Okay, so these bearings are relatively rigid against, you can see here properly, rigid action against radial motion. Okay, so they have the very low amount of coefficient of friction, so they can use at heavy duty rolling contact bearing. Okay, so these are also known as the heavy duty rolling contact bearing because these are having very lowest amount of coefficient of friction. Okay, and they are rigid against radial motion. When there is load is perpendicular direction, so they are very very rigid about this. So such type of bearings I have already explained, use at very high speed, सर्विस. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज योर सिलेंडिकल, सॉरी कंटिन्यूशन इज योर सिलेंडिकल बेयरिंग, रोलर बेयरिंग. सो यू कैन सी हियर इन दिस डायग्राम, दीज आर प्लेस लाइक दिस एंड लुक लाइक दिस. नेक्स्ट इज योर स्फेरिकल रोलर बेयरिंग. ओके, सो दीज बेयरिंग्स आर सेल्फ अलाइन बेयरिंग. वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन बॉल बेयरिंग देयर इज सेपरेट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द सेल्फ अलाइन बेयरिंग. ओके, सो इन दिस रोलर बेयरिंग स्फेरिकल बेयरिंग्स आर नोन एज सेल्फ अलाइन बेयरिंग एंड दीज आर हैविंग द सेल्फ अलाइन फीचर. ओके, एंड विच इज अचीव बाई ग्राइंडिंग वन ऑफ द रेसेस इन फॉर्म ऑफ ए स्फीयर. मीन्स जो इनर रेस और आउटर रेस मे बी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्फेरिकल शेप, राइट. सो दैट्स वाई दीज आर यूज फॉर द सेल्फ अलाइन बेयरिंग. और मिस अलाइनमेंट, दे कैन टॉलरेट द मिस अलाइनमेंट ऑफ द शाफ्ट अप टू प्लस माइनस 1 degree. ओके, अप टू प्लस माइनस 1 degree. एंड व्हेन यूज्ड विथ ए डबल रो ऑफ रोलर्स, दीज कैन कैरी थ्रस्ट लोड इन आइदर डायरेक्शन. व्हेन वी नॉट यूज ओनली वन रो, व्हेन वी विल यूज द टू रोज ऑफ रोलर, सो दे कैन यूज ऑल्सो इन थ्रस्ट टू टेक आउट द थ्रस्ट लोड. ओके, सो यू कैन सी हियर स्फेरिकल रोलर बेयरिंग इज लुक लाइक दिस. नेक्स्ट इज योर निडल रोलर बेयरिंग. सो दीज बेयरिंग्स आर रिलेटिवली स्लेंडर एंड कंप्लीटली फिल द स्पेस. सो इन दिस व्हाट इज द स्पेसिफिकेशन, स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ दिस बेयरिंग इज देयर इज नो नीड ऑफ केज और रिटेनर इज रिक्वायर्ड टू प्लेस आउट द नीडल्स और रोलर्स. ओके, सो दीज आर लुक लाइक दिस, यू कैन सी हियर इन दिस डायग्राम. नेक्स्ट, So, what is the specification where we can use these type of bearing? So, these type of bearings are used where heavy loads are to be carried out with an oscillatory motion. Oscillatory means this is your oscillatory motion, not only for rotation. These are used also for the oscillatory motion. For example, piston pin bearing in heavy duty diesel engine. So, this is the particular application of your needle roller bearing. Okay? So, where they use where the reversal of motion tends to keep the rollers in correct alignment. So, there may not possible to take out the misalignment, or when misalignment may be happened, so they will bring the bearing in the same position. Okay? So, needle bearings are very useful where radial space is limited. Means, radial space means ki where space is limited, you can say that space is limited, also they can use without separator and races. And taper roller bearing, so the rollers and race base of these bearings are truncated, means these are cone, having your cone like shape, and they can use to carry out your both radial and thrust load. Okay, so you can see here in this diagram. This is look like this. Okay? So, thank you.